Hello Cambridge class, and welcome back to our tutorial for HTML. Today we are going to continue from where we ended. Last time, if I can refresh your mind, we came up with this type of a table. We were designing a table, but today we want to do the contact form, how to build a form using HTML. And to do that, obviously, we continue using our text editor, which is Sublime Text. Down up to where it's saying the table, this is where actually our table ended here, when we created this table. So we are going now to include something to this HTML document by creating what we call a contact form. In short, we want to learn how to do a form in HTML. And to do that, first I want to inform my viewers that what is coming down there is a form. So I'll open an H1 tag for heading, and there would say contact form. Let me save that and show you what I'm talking about. So there it's contact form. It simply means what is coming down now is going to be a contact form. So to start a contact form, let me just now open the tag for form. So I would say form. I have a problem with this keyboard. Form. When I open and close the form tags, then I will need to illustrate on the board there what we are trying to build. We are going to create something looking like we need someone to enter the name, and they will enter the name in that box. They will need to enter the email, and they will enter the email there. We need to have gender selection there. Let's first try to put phone number. They'll enter the phone number there. Then we need to select the gender. Sorry, the gender is going to be selected. It's either going to be this circle for male, or you click in the other circle for female. And then we need to have a message box. After you've typed everything, then you type something in the text area there. And from there, let's say you also need to attach a file. We'll say attach or upload a file. So there is this which is going to say attach. Attach your file. So basically that's a simple thing which we are going to work on today. I think that is in focus now. So to begin building the contact form, we are going to go to our text editor, and then from there now would say it is showing on the board, that is the name, then that box. So I would say name there, name, then I'll open the input and close the input. So here the type of entry is going to be text, then we're going to have a name there. So what have we done so far? Let's see what this means. It means that there is going to be a label name, and the box input where the input is going to be accepted is text, and in that we need to have a name. So if I save this and refresh our web page,
we are going to get that. So there's name and the box where we should enter the name. Then the next thing, like shown on the board, we need to put something for the email. To avoid typing and typing, let me just copy this. Simply, let me just go there and say email, and full colon, then you open the input tag, and inside there, we are going to enter the email. We're going to enter the email, and at the far end there, also would say email. And when we save this, let's see the output from the web browser. If I reload, there we have the email. But the only issue that it, instead of going to the next line, it continued on the same line. So it's up to us, the web designers, to ensure that we put a tag which will force it to go to the next line. So if you want to go to the next line, we are going to insert the BR tag. BR tag there. So the BR tag, we save and we reload. We successfully push it to the next line. Then the spacing still is not enough. We put another BR tag to ensure that spacing is as we want it to appear. And let's refresh this. So there, now we have created enough space. Then, according to our format from the board, we're going now to put the one for the phone number. And the procedure is simply going to be the same. To avoid spacing problems again, let me just ensure that I put the BR tags in front there. Then we come there, we want a phone. Phone, then the input for phone is supposed to be a number, not a text email. This time it's a number, which means in that box, it will only be able to accept numbers. And this number is going to be a phone number. And if we save, we try to revisit our page, you would see that the phone has come there. And here we cannot enter any type of text. So as I'm pressing the keyboard, nothing is being typed. But if I press a number, it's going to be displayed. That is the meaning of putting a number here. Then let me also put the BR tag there. And we create now the gender. The gender issue comes next. For the gender, what we are going to do to for the gender, we create an input again. An input. So when we create that input, here it's no longer what we've been entering at the top there. It's going to be a radio. A radio. And then on the other side there, where it is saying name, we call it gender. And gender should have a value. A value is equal to, male. You can say male or female. So let's start with the female. Say female. And when we save this, let's view from the web page what it's going to give us. And obviously it has created gender with that radio button. But it needs to be labeled so that people know that this is for male, this is for female. And like I said, we started for a female. We'll give it a label, and the label is going to be female. We save, we monitor the progress there. If I refresh, now we know that this radio button is for female. We also need to create one for male. We'll do the same. To avoid retyping, I'll just get the whole lot of this. I'll copy. Let me just create space to make our work more readable, so I'll put it there. Now, this time there, we're going to have mail. And outside there, mail. If we save, let's go back to the browser. And we have successfully achieved what we wanted. So there is one for male, one for female. So if I click this one is unchecked. If I click that, this one is unchecked. The reason being that they are carrying the same name. Name is equal to gender. Name is equal to gender. But if you make a mistake there, it's a different name. It means that these two are no longer married. They are separated. And what will happen is that you can actually click in both. Did I save? Let me check if I did the saving here. Control S. Gender, name is equal to gender, name is equal to gender. Let's try. If I click there, I click there. Now both of them are accepting because the name for the input, they are different. To make them dance to one tune, we are going to make sure that they've got a similar or the same name type inside there. Then what else are we going, what next are we supposed to do? When we deal with the gender thing, we need to put the text area for the message, where people can leave their messages. So we'll create another input, and the input we are going to create now is for the message. For the message, and we are going to create a message by open what we call text area to enable us to type something. And if I save this, already I'll need to receive feedback that I have a text area there. And look at that confusion. Obviously, it has come to the same line. We do well to put the BR tag to take it to the next line. So here at the end of gender, actually I had inserted it where it's not supposed to be. I created space, it's supposed to be at the bottom there. And if I save, let me refresh now. And there we have it, but it's still on the same line with the gender issue. So from there, we can now separate the issue by typing the BR tag. Let's just create two spaces to make our work visible. Now if I refresh, obviously now it is working. But if you feel like this text box is too small, you have options using the text area tag. In the text area tag, you can go inside there to add something that can enable your text area to look the way you want it to look. We'd say rows. Rows will be equal to, let's say, 5, for instance, then space. And we are going to say the columns for, that is cos, let's say, let me try 25. It's too much, we're going to reduce. So what simply this means is that we want the text area, this text area we have created. This is the single row. We want it to have another row. So it will grow bigger downwards up to the fifth row. But if for the columns, it will come somewhere around this area because we said 25. And if we saved this and try to refresh, and you would see that it is growing bigger. So it's counting about 5 rows down and about 20 columns, however you interpret it. If you feel it is still too small, you have to increase those two numbers. Then, according to our instructions for today, We'll finish by ensuring that in, let's say someone is applying for the university. Someone is applying for the university, obviously. And they will need to select a course. If you want to go and do computer science, you want to go and do business administration, let's try to put that into our website before we can proceed. And let me just say, we put this just after the gender there. So, immediately after the gender, I will put the options there where they can select. So here I would say select. I didn't open the tag. I would say select. So inside the select tab, that's where we're going to put the options. And those options are what the student would want to pursue in the university. So let's say one wants to do computer science. Computer science there. Let me save this just to give a view of what we are creating now. Would say refresh, and there we have that selection for computer science. So let's ensure we put the BR tags again to create the space. So after computer science select there, we are going to put in BR tags to create space. BR tag. Another BR tag. Let me save and try to refresh the page. Okay, obviously now we've got a space there. This is the exact thing we are trying to create. Let me just increase the spacing between gender and the option for selecting what we want. So, first of all, on top here, I will put another BR tag to increase the spacing. Then, for select, would you say choose your course? What is it that you want to study in the university? And if we refresh the page, we are going to see exactly what we are trying to create. This is what we are trying to create. So there, saying choose your course, and here students are supposed to be choosing courses. So far I've entered computer science. Let me put some more options. Someone doesn't want to do computer science. They want to do something else. We're going to put there, paste. These are university courses we are going to put. The first one is computer science. And let's put another one there. Someone wants to do medicine. If you want to do medicine, it's there. If you don't want to do medicine, you want to do business administration, we put it there. Business admin. Another option, what are we going to do there? Put education, those want to go into education. Then finally, let's put one more there. Environmental engineer. Environmental engineer is also going to come there. Engineer. This is not fair if I'm not going to add my course also. Those want to do computer engineering there. My profession is supposed to be there, and that's when everything will make sense for me. Then we save. Let's go and reload the page now. Okay, after reloading, we can click there and you'll be able to see, you can select whatever you want there. And this is what we call the select option thing. Then finally, we need to ensure that if they are applying into these fields of profession, they need to attach their grade 12 certificate. So I put the BR there to create space again. PR tag, then I would say upload your G12 certificate. We need it there. So I'll open the tag, and this time the tag is going to be input. The input type is going to be a file. So it means you're going to attach a file. And the name of that file will give it a file as well. Let's try to refresh the page. If we do that, now you can see upload your G12. So when you click there, it will enable you to attach a file. If you can choose, do I have any file? Maybe in my documents, PDF files. If I choose, let's say this is my file there, it would say that. And if you want to type something there, you can type anything you want there. Then you can put your name there. If my name is Matthews Buaria, I'll put the name there. And my email to come there, matthewsb2@yahoo.com. Then I can put my phone number there, 0966-272740. And I would select my gender, male. And I would want to pursue Masters of Computer Engineering. And I will type something in the text area, possibly, I want to be considered for the June intake there. So the next thing that we needed to put down there, it's actually the submit button. So let me add the submit button before we can proceed. At the bottom there, someone has typed everything. And I put the BR tag so that we do not come back to this. Then I'm going to put an input tag there. I'll call this submit. Then I'll open an input tag. Then in there I would say submit, and the name will still call it submit, and I will do save this. After saving, let me refresh the page. Now you see someone can submit. When you click there, the form is supposed to be submitted. You can enter your details, you can practice from home, and try to create this page following a step-by-step instruction, and this thing looks so very easy. Hopefully that was very informative, but also remember that all the videos for your class are actually available on my YouTube channel, which is Matthews Buaria. You find all the video tutorials for your class and the other tutorials that can be useful to your siblings from grade 8 to grade 12. So see you next time. If there are questions, please leave the message on YouTube. I'll be able to address your request. Thank you very much, and see you next time.